Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about a galvanic cell which is of different kind known as fuel cell, in which fuels are being used so as to produce a chemical reaction that could eventually create electricity. So let us learn more about it in a very deep. So let us see what is fuel cell. The galvanic cell in which the energy of combustion of fuel is directly converted into electrical energy are called as fuel cells. In this, the reactants are continuously supplied to the electrodes. So let me talk about more about fuel cell. These are the special kind of galvanic cell in which we have to provide continuous flow of the reactant. Unlike galvanic cell that we have did earlier also, like Daniell cell. In Daniell cell or in, for example, in dry cell, the chemicals are present as it is or they are present in a fixed quantity. So we don't have to provide the chemicals again and again. They are present in a specified quantity and at a specified temperature. So in that process, the spontaneous flow of the current will be obtained within the limited amount of the chemicals that is present in that cell. So in that process also, we are getting the electricity. But in this process, we are providing the fuels. So in this case, there is continuous flow of the fuels and the electrolyte that is present in the cell is not in a specific position, means we that is not in a limited supply of the electrolyte. We are increasing it. So as soon as or as more as we provide electrolyte or as more as we provide fuel in this cell, then this kind of cell can produce more amount of electricity as much as we provide the fuel to it. So unlike a galvanic cell or unlike a Daniell cell, so there is no limitation of the particular chemical reagent. In this case, we are providing more and more chemical reactant to it so as to get the electricity. But there are few things that should be maintained so as to get electricity from a fuel cell. In fuel cell, what happens is actually a combustion reaction takes place. Combustion reaction, in the sense as the name itself, fuel cell, a fuel will undergo combustion so as to produce electricity, and that electricity so as to produce energy, and that energy can be converted into electricity eventually. So one of the most example common example about the fuel cell is nothing but the H2O2 fuel cell. So what is H2O2 fuel cell? Let us see. And let us see what is the schematic diagram of it and what is the working of it when we are using an H2O2 fuel cell. So let us look about an H2O2 fuel cell. So friends, this is a schematic diagram of H2O2 fuel cell, in which you could see that this is a huge container that consists of a hot KOH solution. And these are the two electrodes, the one which is anode and other one which is cathode. The both anode and cathode are made up of porous carbon electrodes with platinum. So this consists of a porous material, which is made up of a porous material of a graphite or of a carbon itself with platinum in it. And the most important thing is they are acting like an anode and cathode. When a tube is passed through it in both the electrodes, that is in this electrode the H2 gas is been fueled, is injected, and in this case the O2 gas is been injected in the fuel cell. So this O2 and this H2, since both are gases and they are being connected through this porous carbon electrodes, so this will bubble out those H2 gases and this will also bubble out those O2 gases. So in this case, they can act as a filter also, and hence a pure H2 gas and a pure O2 gas can be combined in this overall reaction so as to get electricity. And in this process, as anode is been showcased by the H2 gas which is entering through that electrode, so that will undergo oxidation and the electrons will eject from here and to cathode, and hence in this process the electrons, the flow of electron takes place, and hence electricity can be generated from this kind of fuel cell. So let us see what are the chemical reaction that takes place in this overall reaction. So this would be the first one. These are the electrode reaction that could take place at anode as well as at cathode. So what happens at anode? Actually, the H2 which is entering through the porous material or the porous carbon, as you can see here, this H2 that will enter in this porous anode, that will react with the KOH solution, which is a concentrated KOH solution, a hot solution. So in this case, the 2 moles of H2 gas will combine with 4 moles of OH minus gas so as to produce 4 moles of water by eliminating 4 electrons. So this 4 electrons that will occupy on the anode, they will travel to the cathode, and in this process the cathode will undergo a reduction process. And in this case, because at cathode O2 is been entering, so therefore the O2 will accept those 4 electrons, but those 4 electrons will be accepted in presence of H2O. So in this process, when O2 will react with 2 times of H2 by producing 4 electrons, then it will produce 4 times of OH minus. And in this case, as we could see, the 4 times of OH minus is being produced. So in first reaction, it has been 4 times of OH minus is been consumed, and again 4 times of OH minus is been produced. So in this case, this OH minus is nothing but the KOH, means there is nothing change in the concentration of OH. And in this case, we could say that only the fuel like H2 and O2 act as a more important role in the formation of the electricity. And let us see what is the overall reaction that we could get. So the overall reaction that we are getting is, the net cell reaction can be written as this 4 electrons and this 4 electrons will cancel out each other, as well as this 4 times OH minus and this times 4 times OH minus will cancel out each other. And in this case, 2 times H2 which is present on the left hand side will cancel out the 2 times of H2 which is present on the right hand side as 4 times of H2. So the thing that is left here is 2 times of H2, while this H2 has been cancelled from here and only 2 times of H2 has been remained here. So therefore the thing which is left on the left hand side is 2 times of H2 plus O2. So this is how the cell reaction occurs. And as you could see, there is a formation of H2, means the hydrogen gas and oxygen gas will combine with each other, they will undergo combustion process and will show the product as water, which is of liquid state, or this can be vaporized also, because the condition which is present in the overall cell is a hot KOH solution. So there are possibility that the H2 will be evaporated or H2 will be condensed later after. So let me tell you the overall reaction that has taken place here by looking at the reaction again. In this process, what actually happens is the H2 gas which enters at the anode, it undergoes oxidation so as to produce 4 times of electron. This 4 times of electron will be consumed by the O2 gases with the help of H2O2, and that H2 as well as O2, they will combine with each other so as to form water molecule. So in this case, we are getting water molecule as well as we are also getting electricity. So therefore, this fuel cell becomes very much efficient in providing electricity as well as a product which is very helpful for a human need. So let us see what are the advantages and the uses that we are using if we use a fuel cell. So the first advantages and the uses that we could see for a fuel cell is, the first thing is it is non-polluting, because the fuels that are being used is H2O2 and oxygen. Oxygen is non-polluting, that is for sure. So in this case, the H2 and O2 will combine with each other to form water, and that byproduct or that product during this process is not harmful. In fact, it is very much necessary for us. And hence, this is the main advantage of a fuel cell whenever we use H2O2 fuel cell. Talking about the next thing, This has been used by astronauts also. The astronauts, they could take this thing in spacecraft and they can utilize those H2 gases and oxygen gases, and they can generate electricity as well as they can generate pure water for drinking. So therefore, it produces H2, which can be used by astronauts, and hence astronauts can use. And earlier also, they used to do this kind of process by taking fuel cell, and with the help of fuel cell, they could get a pure water in space. So we were talking about the spacecrafts, in which we could say that they provide a very good efficiency. Many much more of the fuel cell, this was an example of H2 to fuel cell, but there are also very more fuel cells which provide 40% of the efficiency compared to a normal thermal fuel. And what is thermal fuel? Thermal fuel is thermal cell is a cell in which the heat energy has been converted into electrical energy. So it provides more, 40% more efficiency than the thermal cells. So therefore, the fuel cells are play a very vital role in our they could play a vital role in our future also. And in fact, the fuel cells were also being used in cars earlier, but now they are not being used, but they were very efficient earlier also. And talking about this thing, this is a very harmful thing and very useful thing that we are using in spacecraft right now. So fuel cell plays a very important role. I hope you have understood it. And so thank you friends for watching this video, and I hope you have got an idea that what are the cell reactions that took place in an H2O2 fuel cell. And please share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.